I'm young. I think I can still experiment a little. I'm confident about this film. This film has a very unique voice compared to Pellichoopulu. I keep the dialogue as the last tool to emote. The main tools that you should use to emote is cinematography. You will hear Telugu, you will hear English, you will hear Tamil, you will hear Konkan, and you will hear a little bit of Russian in the film.
Tharun, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Hemant. Thank you, man.
It's almost been 2 years since you made Pellichoopulu, and we all know how big a hit it was. You know, went on to win 2 national awards, and there were a lot of other awards, you know, state awards as well as Filmfare awards and all that stuff. So what was your state of mind back then? Were you really confused about what to do next, or how long did it take for all that to sink in?
I was extremely anxious, man. I didn't know how to take it in. There was too much of energy. It was extremely positive. The response was crazy. I was overwhelmed by emotions. So for me to actually put all that aside and start fresh again took a little while. But it also made me clear about what matters the most. And then I realized that what matters the most is to write a good story. Mm-hmm. And to just get to that point took a little while. But I think it was worth it. I needed that time. Aa thondar paatlo nen malli if I had immediately written something and send it over to a producer or something, I think I would have been in a different state of mind. I wouldn't have been thinking honestly about the story. So I needed that little bit of time.
So what, it took you almost 6 months to get out of the
zone? Yeah, 6 months, 8 months tarvata I had to sit down, understand what is there in the industry, because there are some options that, you know, after a hit film you have to do it with this person, yeah. Then you go that other step and all that I understood. I figured out that my bank balance is important as well and all that. Kakapote, to me honestly, it was all about hitting it right the second time also, and the only way I can do it is how I did it the first time. So that clarity came through after 8 months, and then I wrote the script, pre-production and everything. There was no delays from anybody else, any other person's end.
There's a lot of doubts among people, right? So, especially after a hit like Pellichoopulu,
right?
You could have worked with anybody, you know, right. a big name, a right. big banner, a bigger banner, you know,
right?
Probably you would have earned more money, you know,
right?
That's definitely the case, right. Whether you agree to it or not,
right?
But you're working with a lot of these newcomers for your second film, Ee Nagariniki Emaindhi.
Right.
So what was the reason behind that?
See, first thing is, I think that this script requires a lot of fresh faces. The moment you put somebody, it becomes like it's whether it's a real boxing match or a WWF match. All right. I didn't want it to be anywhere close to any fakeness, number one. And I think that the moment you put fresh faces, you have no baggage of who he is or what he is doing and everything. You're automatically zapped into a world where you're not recognizing that person. You assume that the world is fresh and you're listening to a story. I somehow feel that that's the right way to approach this particular, this film. So I went ahead with that gut feeling, and also I think I need a lot more experience to work with stars, because one thing is I don't want to do something to tarnish their image. And it's a huge risk to actually work with somebody big like Pawan Kalyan garu, Mahesh Babu garu, or Junior NTR garu. They are huge stars. To actually understand them and weave a story around them is going to be very difficult. And I don't think I'll take up that anytime soon, because I'm young. I think I can still experiment a little. And once I reach an age where I'm running out of ideas, then I will probably sit down and say, okay, let me make a big film. Let me work on a star's image and then tailor something for them.
Right. So I remember, I think it was about 6-7 years ago when YouTube was a big thing, when a lot of you in Hyderabad were making short films. There was your group, there was Nakama group, and there were other filmmakers
from
a lot of colleges also. So there was this competition, sort of competition between groups, right? Like who puts out the most interesting film or who wins a competition.
Right.
So what was that phase like?
There was definitely a competition of sorts, or at least let's get better at it and all that. But as time progressed, I realized that creativity is not about competition at all. Creativity should be about collaboration. I think it is about a lifestyle that you lead. So let's say that, you know, you're your peers are there. You obviously have competition with other journalists and everything as well. But I think the way we look at it should change. I think now I'm looking at it differently. I look at other filmmakers' films and I'm super excited by it, genuinely excited. Before, when I used to watch short films from other people, I was like, okay, I will beat this frame, I will do this, I will do that. Now I'm open to honestly looking and listening to really good stuff from other films and other content as well. And it is actually improving my mental health. And you know,
very important.
Yeah, and it is also making me a more positive person, and I'm getting a lot more ideas onto the plate. So I loved Arjun Reddy. When I watched Arjun Reddy, I was like flabbergasted by that film. I was like, it just took some time to sink in. Ghazi did the same, Kshanam did the same thing. Care of Kancharapalam, a recent film that's also from Suresh Productions, it's coming through. And then Ravikant Parepu's other films. So I am having a blast interacting with these guys, watching their films, and you know, learning something from them, and also passing on something. These interactions are really good, they're very healthy. And during the short film time also, I slowly kind of went that way. I started meeting Hussein, Sujit. We used to bounce off ideas. We wanted to collaborate and do something sometime. Okay. So it was a very interesting time. Initial phases were definitely a little competitive.
Very competitive.
But after that, I think they're good guys. And I love to hang out with them and interact with them.
Right. Now, for a lot of young filmmakers, it's not their first film, but the second film dictates how long their journey is going to be.
Yeah,
right?
Somehow like, they say that stereotype, man. I'm damn bloody scared.
But is that a stereotype? But didn't you feel any pressure when you're making a second film?
Somehow I just wired my brain into thinking that this is it's okay. Screw this shit. Let me just make something on there. I don't know if that's the right attitude or the wrong attitude, but I think I just went ahead and had fun. There was this zeal at the beginning of this project to actually beat Pellichoopulu.
In terms of what?
In terms of this massive demon that it had become sitting on my damn shoulders. It was becoming a pain to overthrow that demon and make another film. And I think in a way, we've succeeded. I'm confident about this film. This film has a very unique voice compared to Pellichoopulu. And I know that it'll beat Pellichoopulu in a lot of aspects.
Okay.
So,
can you talk more about it? Like, you're tempting us with all these vague things that you're saying. But
Karl, I think in terms of camera, we've invested more. Obviously, the budgets were bigger for this film. Double the budget of Pellichoopulu, I think, or double a little more than that. So the cameras that we've used are we shifted from Red to Arri Alexa, and a lot of filmmakers would know that everybody prefers Arri Alexa over Red, most of them. And we used anamorphic lenses, which was a choice that I wanted to have in Pellichoopulu, but because of lack of budget, I could not do that. So this time we got that anamorphic lens. So what it does is it gives a very vintage feel to your film, and a vintage cinema feel to your film, because it has certain optics which are distorted and which are aesthetically distorted in that old sense to kind of give you that nostalgic film feel. So that was an expensive affair for Pellichoopulu. I couldn't have it. It was a heartbreaking choice for me to not take. But this time I fulfilled that dream, got that. Cinematographer changed. Nagesh has his own style of cinema. Nagesh has this really neat looking frames, very good lighting, and you know, this composition is very intact. Niket is a really
more dynamic
guy, moves the camera a lot. So this subject I wanted to test it out with somebody like that. And Niket proved to be a really nice choice for this particular subject. Apart from that, Lata has improved. Lata, my wife, production designer for Pellichoopulu, she's done a lot more work. She's kind of understood how to fill spaces, make layers. You can see that in this film. It doesn't look like a film made in the budget that it was actually made in. And sound, we invested huge amount of money in sound, but I think it's going to pay off. Definitely. La La Land lo vaadina technical equipment that they use for sing sound, the same equipment was used on our set. So that is a first for a Telugu film, and it sounds very different now. It sounds, at least the sound, sing sound is on par with dubbing, at least the quality of the sound. And we shot at various locations. And I don't think nobody's ever shot Goa like we have so far in Telugu.
Yeah, the trailer actually gives a very different
trailer light doesn't do any justice to the visuals of the film. There's a lot more that you can watch. There's a lot more Goa vibe in the entire film. And also you will hear Telugu, you will hear English, you will hear Tamil, you'll hear Konkan, and you'll hear a little bit of Russian in the film.
Okay, because it's Goa.
Yeah, it's Goa, and a lot of, all the characters are very authentic. So you won't sit in the theater and say, okay, this is a Telugu film, hero, heroine, this will happen, that will happen, okay, towards the end this will happen, all that is washed off. Definitely it has a buddy comedy format, there's travel and everything involved, but the plot will not give you any twists or anything. You'll feel like you're having a conversation with four friends. You're on a mini trip to Goa in the theater for 2 hours for that 150 rupees you paid. So that's what I can promise.
When you say that, it doesn't feel like a traditional Telugu film, right?
Right.
Is there a trick to writing the kind of stuff that you write? You know?
Yes. So basically, I follow a three-act structure and all that on the basic format of it, a beginning, a middle, and an end. All that is there. I also understand inciting incident, midpoints, conflict resolutions or whatever. But for me, the most important thing is the intricacies of writing a scene. All right, how you write a scene, how you enter the scene, how you exit the scene, how you write character through dialogue. And I keep the dialogue as the last tool to emote. That should be like the last tool to emote. The main tools that you should use to emote is cinematography, acting, blocking, production design, shot design. And only if you lose out on all those aspects will you write dialogue. Dialogue should be the last thing that should convey emotion, because that is just a, otherwise you can just type it as a Facebook or a Twitter status and put that stuff out there. Cinema is not that. Cinema is everything but dialogue. It's irony that I got the best National Award for dialogues, but I did everything but focus on dialogue. But I think that is very important, and I think that is the key for me to kind of, that's my secret is what I can say.
So are you looking for that punch in every scene, you know, because in the trailer there is this shot where somebody asks.
No, I don't look at any punch or anything actually.
No, a punch in the sense that, like, let me give you an example. This guy asks him, enter office kelleda, yalla nagal punch me. He says it as a very matter of fact.
Right.
But for us it's so funny.
Right.
I'm talking about punch like that.
Right. You know? So, no, I just try to put everybody in character. Those characters are slightly distorted, and that distortion is magnified because of cinema. That is all. Okay. I don't want to kind of go out of, I don't want them to go out of character and do something which is comical, because I believe in character consistency. It should all fall like a magic trick, and at that one moment it should go boom. So, honesty has to be in all departments to achieve that one effect. So I think that I think about real characters, I put them in that spot, I write my inciting incident or midpoints and whatever, keep that format ready. The format is pretty simple. If you see in most of the films, even in that rom-com Pellichoopulu that I've done, or this film, this is a buddy comedy format, that's a rom-com format. But that inside, within that container, what is the content that you're pouring in is what is the trick that I have.
Okay.
And I it's very simple. I keep it very simplistic. The only thing is, I find certain key moments in normal day-to-day life that are funny. If we have a conversation with each other, we might not think it's funny, but somebody who sees our character as a third person might find something that I say very funny. And that is the moment I try to capture when I'm writing. And it is consistent with my character, but as a third person point of view, it's just funny, that's all.
Okay.
So that is the essence of my writing, is what I think.
Okay, the origins of Ee Nagariniki Emaindhi, like, how did this idea come up? Like, were you influenced by certain aspects that you went through in your own life? Or did you see something which triggered this whole story for you?
Yeah, there are, one thing that I've seen is, we as a generation, we are very, some of us are very scared to kind of put our ambitions out there. That is what I felt. We are constantly bombarded by fear. Fear of humiliation, or fear of what will everybody think.
And, log kya kahenge?
Yeah, that has destroyed us. and that imaginary log or imaginary people or who vallem anukuntaru, that imaginary thing does not exist. It is your own fear of failure because of a standard that you've set to yourself. But I see a lot of people who boldly go out there, do their Instagram stuff or their YouTube or whatever little way, they don't complain. They have internet, they have a phone, that's all they require. They want to put their talent out there. It's just about taking that leap of faith. And I've seen that a lot of talented, good people and people who are tasteful do not want to go out there because they're looking at that perfection. You know, that this is not me, this is, I have to put my best foot forward. No, you have to put your foot forward first. And I think that is what this film is about. It's about battling that fear within you. And I've seen that happen to a lot of people, and I've seen a lot of talented people not come out there, and they're still cribbing about everything else in life. They're cribbing about this cinema not being the best, this scene not being the best. Are idhi vidu copy kottadra adi vaadi ichchesadra nu em chestunav. You are not putting your foot forward. You think that you are extremely talented, but you are not, because you are not putting your foot forward. And that is consistent with a lot of people, a lot of their failures, and a lot of people who have stepped back from their passion. And I think that is what this film addresses. So
did you discover all this while writing it, or did you write it because it was the theme that
I wrote it because this is the theme. I wrote the theme first.
Okay.
It's about, I start the film with a debate that I have in my mind. I say, this is the underlying theme that I want to talk about. This is what I want to communicate with society or an audience in general. And on top of that, I write a story and weave all the other intricacies.
Okay, that's been very consistent with how you have worked over the years, is it?
Yes.
Like the theme
yes.
comes first and then you build
yes.
on top.
For a couple of short films, no. I had to write a story because it was 48 hours. Then it wasn't my choice. So
that 48 hours reminds me, Anukokunda was your, how do I put it, breakthrough?
Yeah.
It got you noticed by everybody, yeah. right? So how did that change your life? Like, did that lead to a feature film directly, or was it just your calling card? Like, okay, I'm the director of Anukokunda. Can we work something out?
No, so basically before that I had a huge ego about myself that I will only make moral films where I will change society through my short films. That too.
Okay.
Through 15 minute short films I will change society and I will tell them that this is how they should live. And Jeppe, I was class big thunder under pretty short film. So whether it would be about the morals of somebody or something of that sort. And to be very honest, they were very boring short films, not because I wanted to talk about some burning issue, because I didn't know the craft well back then. So I was blinded by this ignorant this thing that, you know, people who do romantic comedy are useless filmmakers. They are taking the easy way out and all that, all these things I had. Okay, ammayin betti nu music bettese laksha views vaste pedda topu gaadu ane feeling lo nenu tittedi andarni ikkada chai daakkuntu ma dosulto. I was like sitting there and I was cribbing about everybody else. So then what happened was, there was a point of time in my life where I had to make a damn decision whether this is a hobby or a profession. And I had to prove to a lot of people that, you know, I'm worth it. At that point of time, a 48 hour contest happened, and I picked the genre from a hat, and it said romantic comedy. And I said, shit. Screw this shit, I'm not doing this at all. So anukuna, just because I've already told my friends that I'm not so low to do a romantic comedy, I won't put a girl in some nice music and kick. Now this was a do or die position. The audience in my life were waiting, what will this fellow do? And I was like, even if there's a thunder or a lightning that strikes me in the bum, I will still make this short film. No matter what, I'll make it to the best of my ability. So I just did that. That situation, that pressure just made me come out of my comfort zone. Mm-hmm. I went and did a rom-com and I put it out there, and it just became the highest viewed Telugu short film at that point of time.
Yeah.
And I was shocked that we can even get so many views. So people would say that some people had ringtones. Ritu started getting famous, the music and the girl got famous. And I was thinking to myself, I was reanalyzing everything about cinema then. And I thought that, you know, there is some thought process and there is a little bit of honesty and heart also into what you put. It's about balancing that boat. So, yeah, right after that, I could show the viewership. I mean, after I got so many views, I started getting calls from a couple of producers. I met them. But I had to go back and find my style, because definitely Anukokunda was a badly, technically not that great short film. And I had to find what I can do differently and what I can consider is my style and what will make me confident to make a feature film. That was Sainma. So Sainma changed the game for me.
Okay.
And out of a lot of frustration for I thought the industry is like this, like that. I was scribbling about everybody else. Then I realized I have to go back to ground zero, make a short film where I am completely free, void from all these assumptions, and make a film as a film. That was Sainma. And then when Sainma happened, I was confident to make a feature.
Okay. So a lot of short filmmakers, I can say this, that they look up to you, Sujit. You know, you are this biggest success stories.
Right.
Somebody who made that good transition from short films to feature films.
Right.
But it's not so simple, right? Like, there are still a lot of short filmmakers who continue doing what they're doing, but then they've not been able to make that successful jump.
Right.
So where do you think that there is that gap? You know, why is that gap so wide for a lot of people?
I think you have to explore yourself as a short filmmaker, number one. I mean, let's forget about short filmmaker. When you're making short films or when you're exploring that art form, first thing is you have to explore your own style. You also have to cater to the business aspect of what you're going to do. As in your career, if you're going to make a feature film which is going to release in theaters, it is going to cost a lot of money, which means that every movie is like a startup, which means you have to go with a PPT. You have to convince your investors, and then you'll have to tell them that, you know, your return on investment will be this much. So there is a business to the entire art form as well. So you'll have to balance it. I think you'll have to find your style as a filmmaker, and you'll also have to create a portfolio and tell them that this works.
Okay.
So that is very important. And I think a lot of people, where they are becoming redundant, is at the genre. Don't stick to one genre, saying that, you know, don't confine yourself or compartmentalize yourself into one little this thing that I am just going to make romance, I am just going to make comedy, I am just going to make drama. While you're at it, while you've bought some time from society and your parents, okay, I have 1 year, use that 1 year effectively, try to do all genres possible. And that is going to define you as a filmmaker to yourself. You're going to learn in that entire process. You have a great portfolio created. Out of them, one probably might go viral as well.
Yeah.
So that will do much better. Don't try to mimic the next viral thing. Instead, find it yourself by exploring different genres.
Let me rephrase what I had in mind. Right? If you're a good short filmmaker, does it mean that you have it in you to make a good feature film? Or is it a whole different ball game altogether?
No, man. I think when you make a good film, whether it is 10 minutes or 2 hours, it's always the same. So I don't think if you're a good short filmmaker, you will make good. Yeah, if you're a good short filmmaker, you will make a good feature film as well. I don't think there's any doubt about that.
Okay, so I've heard this. It's not a complaint, but an observation which a lot of producers and directors within the industry have, right? So, because it's a short film, right? Like 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Right.
You have a story, you create a mood for those 10, 15 minutes.
Right.
But if you have to make something for 2 hours, sustaining that emotion becomes a problem.
Right.
It's not that simple, right? Because the runtime is that long, you know? So,
yeah. That is there. So, basically, I think that is when you have to study structure and script writing. Once you understand the format of writing, the structure of writing, and once you've read about screenwriting properly, I don't think any format can actually scare you as a filmmaker, whether it's 10 minutes or whether it is 2 hours. And a lot of people complain that, you know, some feature films are like short films. That is the most ignorant remark of anybody that I can talk. Tell them that, you know, the production design isn't great, or, you know, the cinematography isn't great, but short film laga undi ante. What do you mean? You don't know anything about filmmaking. You make that ignorant remark on other people, then everybody is lost in the system. He's made a 2-hour feature film. In the length is 2 hours. Short film laga undi ante. So these things have to really change. It's also the ignorance of the producers or whoever, people with money who call themselves producers, should also study cinema. At the same time, these guys should also do it. Should be like a win-win situation. So I think that's where the problem is. We shouldn't look at short films or other formats of cinema as a stepping stone to something. These are just different canvases or different lengths. And you know, and I, that's what I'm saying. Even established filmmakers should step out and do short films now. If they have a story to tell for 10 minutes, 15 minutes. And I think that shouldn't even be like a criteria for judging somebody. Like, you know, short films padi chesadu ippudu feature film ki ready ayyadu. It should be the individual, the short filmmaker or the filmmaker himself, that you know, I've done these to experiment, I know I can make a feature, now I have a 2-hour story, let me do it. All right, now I have a 15-minute story, let me go back to making a short film. That's all.
Now, this is your second film right. As a director, second feature film.
Right.
Done a lot of short films. When you look back at your own work, who's do you see any influences on yourself, any filmmakers or
see,
any
huge influences of Maniratnam sir on my writing, the way I kind of write female characters, because I am absolutely in love with all Maniratnam sir's women in his films. So I think unknowingly there's a huge influence. Jandhyala garu's influence is there, and I also think any other recent films that I watch, also something that I'm excited by, I definitely have an influence on it. But I make sure that that is a good influence, the first thing.
Very important.
That's very important to actually have a good influence, and also to make sure that you know you're not just very in a very unprofessional way, you're just cutting and pasting something. Instead, it should flow really well, those influences, and I think it should be very honest, your experience. And I think you should tell a really good story at the heart of it. That is all, that amalgamation is what is good cinema, is what I feel. And Pellichoopulu appudu I had a very solid influence from Maniratnam sir's Maunaragam. Maunaragam, there was a scene where he lures her out of the classroom. Mm-hmm. And Nandu does the same to Ritu.
Yeah, yeah.
And that particular scene, I just rewrote it, like literally it was just there in the back of my mind. And then my team members actually called that out, and they said, shit, that's exactly the same. I said, shut up, I never copied it. And then I actually watched Maunaragam again. It was exactly the same setting, the same thing, almost the same way he lures her out. And I was like, shit, this man has a heavy influence in Japan. I had to rewrite that entire thing and put that little tag towards the end where Nandu says, Maunaragam chudaleda meeru ani antaru.
Okay, made this successful transition into film, but have you kept yourself abreast with what's happening in the short film scene right now?
No.
In Telugu? Like, no. Are you completely out of that?
Completely out of that zone. And I regret it, because sometimes it becomes so self-obsessive, that filmmaking.
But I'm sure a lot of people would be sending their work to your portfolios to...
it is way too... It's very difficult to handle communication after whatever little fame or whatever you get after a film. It is extremely sad, but Facebook, I'm off Facebook, I'm off Twitter, and I'm also deleting Instagram, hopefully. I'm just keeping away. And Gmail also, I get a lot of mails, but it is too overwhelming. And I don't think I can actually sit down and filter it one day. Yeah. I've always thought that I should respond to everybody who wrote to me. That's never happened before Pellichoopulu. Even my relatives, when they call or message, I don't reply back. I have a bad name there. And that has become even worse now. So I don't think I can handle that shit. So I think I've always wanted to segregate all these things and actually keep abreast of what is happening on the short film front. It's never happened. I hope I get a break after this film to actually see if I can actually make a short film and be in touch with that part of the thing as well.
Okay, how has Telugu film industry been to you in the last couple of years? Like, especially after such a huge success like Pellichoopulu, right? Have they been very warm to you, very welcoming?
Yeah,
or,
absolutely.
Or have you gotten a reality check about what industry is like?
No, no, no. There is no bad thing. First of all, there is no industry. They're just people working in film. the actual industry people are the people who are lightmen who work on union and the food guys and all that. So these guys actually formed a union because it's easy to approach them, it's easy to get a system and all that. Everybody else are just either celebrities or actors or this thing and stuff like that. And if each one of them have a very unique personality. You can't really put all of them into one box and say it's an industry, number one. They all behave very differently. They are different in different situations. And in total, I think I've had the opportunity, the people from the film industry or whatever, they have been really kind, as in they have really, I think all these people come together and call themselves the industry because they love cinema.
Yeah.
And they love Pellichoopulu. I always see that spark in their eyes when they talk to me. They say they love the film and all that. It just is very heartwarming to see that response. And nobody's ever ill-treated me in any which way. They've always made me feel at home, even if Ramanaidu Studios become like my second home now. And I'm happy to be here, happy to be making films with people who are genuinely curious about cinema, who love cinema. It's been a dream come true, man. I'm living the dream. Don't have anything to complain about.
On a parting note, I want to ask you this. 5 things that any aspiring filmmaker or writer should keep in mind before they put out their work. Okay, now number one, you have said that you have to put your foot forward first.
Yeah, put your foot forward first. But work in different genres. Have healthy habits, because your health will go for a toss when you're making films. That is one thing. Be nice to everybody. Let your work speak for you. I guess these are the few things that I think. And have fun at it while you're working in films, because it's going to be a long, tedious process till you get that one break. Even after you get that one break, it'll still be a tedious process. So you have to surround yourself with positive people who constantly love cinema. And they are in your vibe, they are matching with your wavelength. And I think you'll go to sleep peacefully, get up in the morning with some inspiration that you will go meet those same people together, collaborate and make some good cinema. So I think surrounding yourself with such people is very important as well.
Okay, now that your film is releasing soon, what next after that? Like, have you thought about it? Like, what's going to come up for the next?
I have some really, really weird ideas.
Weird?
Yeah,
weird. Define weird. How weird is weird?
Weird, and I just want to move away from humor again. I just want to do something extremely dramatic. I have a thriller in mind. I have a crime comedy. Crime comedy is also there. That's also very interesting. So I want to kind of dabble with different genres. I don't want to stick to the same thing, like Pellichoopulu director. I don't want that tag at all. I just want to be as invisible as possible. Even if people don't remember my name, it's fine. But if they remember the film, that's great. And I think I want to present different kinds of cinema. And that is what I planned. And I don't have a story as of now. I always believe that after one project, I'll focus on one story and finish that off. I don't have like a future plan. It gets interesting that way. Otherwise, it becomes very boring.
Right. All right, Tharun, thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank
All
you
the best for your film.
Thank you so much, man.